Oh, hello. I didn't see you there. I know. Let's orchestrate some talking brass. Do you remember us creating a heroic superhero entrance theme together in Let's Orchestrate episode number 2 with horns, trumpets and all of the good stuff? No? Oh. Better check it out. Here's a viewer submission from Alex, who got inspired by that orchestration recipe and made it his own. This is amazing! There's great dynamics on the brass, and the programming of the short trumpet repetitions is on point to make this an uplifting fanfare. The composition remains close to the sound example from the recipe, and the listener immediately gets what this theme is about. Thanks for your submission, Alex! Today, we'll score some seriously epic choir action, garnished by a brass section that has a bit of a conversation together. The idea is taken again from the wonderful little orchestration recipes, the most fun and generously priced piece of music education I've seen so far, and we'll use it to come up with our own composition. As always, we'll write one theme together and then compare it to the original, as well as three more themes that I prepared using the same orchestration recipe. This is what the course example sounds like. Holy moly, that choir goes ham! The orchestration recipe has 6 steps. A simple and engaging choir foundation, short and driving low strings poly chords, rhythmic timpani highlights, and 3 types of talking brass. Horns, a trumpet, and a trombone, with a conversation of unexpected staccato interjections. To get started with this composing exercise, I load up the instruments and try to recreate the orchestration recipe. This is very helpful to me, because once you've set everything up and understand how the instruments work together, your own themes can flow out of your brain unobstructedly. The written explanations on the orchestration recipes help me make good writing choices, and they guide me through this, for me, unfamiliar orchestration style of brass instruments having some serious chit-chat. Step 1. Choir. With a male and octaved female choir section, we'll write a simple riff, interesting enough to hook the listener through the first presentation, yet sparse enough to give space for the brass interjections later on. In the second half, the riff opens into an epic climax, during which all the other instruments pause, making the choir appear even larger than it is. I recorded the male choir, copy-pasted the MIDI to the women, and simply transposed it up an octave. Step 2. Strings. I use an ensemble patch to step record dark and tense polychords. This theme is written in C minor, but we'll add some spicy extra notes, like a D flat. We want to keep a low register to give enough space for the brighter brass on top. I'll compress the velocities a bit to make the accents tighter, humanize them, and shorten the notes to prevent overlaps. Step 3. Timpani. We'll use a timpani for anticipation and rhythmic highlights. The rhythm should be mixed up a bit to stay unpredictable while the choir and strings are shouting at us. Due to my current living situation, for this video I only had access to the free BBCSO Discover timpani, and I was missing a few mic positions to make it fit well. I'm still using it, but double it with some low drums. We record them together in one take, and the MIDI is exactly the same. Step 4. Horns. After the first repetition of the choir riff, our horn section has something to say. A single rhythmic statement that respects our home key C minor and uses notes from the choir riff. At the end, there's a rip effect for the final stab of the theme. Step 5. Trumpet. A trumpet enters the scene and needs to add its opinion to the statement of the horn. It goes louder and strays away from our key signature. It's not amused and needs to communicate that. Step 6. Trombone. A trombone tries to mediate between the two arguing parties and brings the argument back home to our C minor key before everything gets overthrown by the shattering choir climax that finishes off the song and us. Let's listen back to the cross example, then three more themes that I created with the same recipe, and conclude with our new theme. Which theme is your favorite? 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5? Let me know your favorite in the comments and send me over your theme with this orchestration recipe to have it featured in one of the next episodes of Let's Orchestrate. Happy composing, and I'll see you soon!